In this video, I'll teach you how to install Docker on Ubuntu and Windows 11. I'm not covering Mac OS on purpose because Mac installation is pretty straightforward. You go to the installation dock, download the appropriate disk image, double-click and install, and have lots of fun. This is the fourth lesson of Docker from Zero to Infinity series. My name is Raghav. Let's get started. Let's install Docker on Ubuntu first. Since Linux is the most suitable platform for containers and is also widely used in web servers. The easiest and recommended way of installing Docker on Ubuntu is through the apt repository. That's the method I'm going to cover. Unless you're in a highly customized environment, you won't need to install and manage things manually. Great, so what we're installing here is Docker Engine. If you're not sure what I'm referring to, watch my previous video on Docker's architecture. The engine comes packed with the Docker desktop UI too, but if you're good with the CLI, I don't see why you'd need it. I'm going to copy all the commands from their official installation docs and run them in my terminal. First, these commands install Docker's GPG key. This basically tells your system that Docker's repository is a trusted source to download packages from. Then, they add Docker's repository into your local apt sources. Now you can use the install command to download and install the complete Docker engine onto your system. Let's verify that Docker works. Great, so the installation was successful, but there is still a problem. If you try to run Docker without root, you get a permissions failure. This is because the Docker daemon runs as a root and binds to a Unix socket. If you want to talk to the daemon, you need to access the socket. And to access the socket, you need to be root. But there's an easy way to allow other users to interact with the daemon. When you install Docker on Ubuntu, it creates a new Linux user group called Docker. Users in this group have access to the socket. Just add yourself or any other user to this group. And now if you try to run Docker commands, it works. Note that in some Linux distributions, the Docker group isn't automatically created for you. You should create it manually and then restart the Docker daemon. If you're an advanced user, you can even run the Docker daemon as a non-root user. This is much more secure, especially if you're setting up a production server. But this has some limitations, so make sure to read its documentation carefully. I've shared the link in the description. I also highly recommend you read the documentation on post-installation steps for Linux. This is for advanced configurations. Finally, you can also configure Docker to start automatically when your system starts. These commands enable the Docker and containerd units in systemd. And that's it. You're now ready to play with Docker on Ubuntu. Now, before we move to installing Docker on Windows, I'll explain how it works under the hood on non-Linux platforms. This is important because on Mac and Windows, you will run into seemingly random technical issues while setting up and working with Docker. So I highly recommend you watch this part of the video. But if you just want to install Docker, feel free to skip this section for now and directly jump to the Windows installation. Docker and Linux containers in general rely on specific features such as namespaces and control groups. These features are only supported by Linux, which is why initially Docker only worked on Linux platforms. In order to support Windows or macOS, Docker provides a piece of software called Docker Desktop. Under the hood, this tool actually runs a Linux virtual machine called Mobi, which is highly optimized for Docker, but still very minimal. Docker Engine is then run inside this VM, and lots of tricks are used to give you the illusion that Docker is running directly on the system. This way, you can interact with Docker in the same way, regardless of whether you're on Linux or non-Linux platforms. In Windows, Docker uses WSL or Hyper-V, and on Mac, it uses Hyperkit. These are virtualization technologies designed to create VMs for the respective platforms. When you're running Docker on these platforms, you might run into issues or behaviors which you won't see on Linux machines. For example, directory traversals can be really slow on Mac. These issues happen because of the VM layer in between. Be sure to check out the known issues documentation if you encounter such weird problems. Coming specifically to Windows, when you try to install Docker, you will see a bunch of terms being thrown around. WSL2, Hyper-V, Windows containers, blah, blah, blah. Let me simplify this for you. To run Docker on Windows, you need to choose a backend, WSL2 or Hyper-V. Hyper-V is a virtualization technology for Windows. It lets you run multiple operating systems as VMs inside your Windows machine. Remember how I told you that Docker runs a virtual machine on non-Linux platform? Yeah, for Windows, that's Hyper-V. Docker uses Hyper-V to run a Linux VM and then runs the Docker engine inside it. But Hyper-V is not available on Windows Home Edition. If you're on Home, you can't use the Hyper-V backend. WSL stands for Windows Subsystem for Linux. This feature allows you to run Linux directly on Windows and consumes much lesser resources compared to a full-blown Hyper-V virtual machine. WSL2 runs on all Windows editions. All you need to do is install Docker with the WSL2 backend. You only need Hyper-V when you have advanced enterprise use cases. Enough theory. Let's install Docker on Windows. I'm running Windows 11 Home Edition 64-bit. But these instructions will also work on Windows 10. First, I'll download the installer executable from the official source. This is going to take a while. Let's double-click and install Docker Desktop now. Make sure that you're using the WSL2 backend. This should be the default setting already. Now we have to wait some more. After installation, you might run into this error, which says that your WSL2 version needs to be updated. Fixing this is pretty straightforward. Just open the Windows terminal and run WSL update. Once this is complete, you will be able to open up the Docker Desktop UI. Also, go ahead and play around with the CLI. If you run into any other issues mentioning WSL or Hyper-V, I highly recommend you watch the previous section where I explain these terms in more detail. If you've already watched it, then it's best to look at the documentation. Congratulations! You have successfully installed Docker on your Windows machine. Time to get productive. It was pretty easy to install Docker on a single machine following these instructions. But I have a question to test your real DevOps skills. Let's say you have 5,000 Ubuntu servers running across 3 different cloud providers and some on-prem data centers. You have to prepare them so your organization could deploy containers on them. How will you install Docker on all of these servers? Tell me your solution in the comments below and let's get this discussion started. In my next video, I will teach you Docker's complete workflow by containerizing a real application. Keep leveling up your DevOps skills with me. Subscribe to my channel now. If you learned something interesting from my video, show me your support. Press the like button and share it with your peers. I will see you in the next video.